there's a lot of people that's kind of talking about Ayesha Curry right now. And, you know, when I saw this, I said, let me really listen to it a few times. And, you know, I see a lot of brothers going in, and also some women is going in on Ayesha Curry as well. Now, for those of you who don't know who she is, or maybe you just heard the name before, she is the wife of Stephen Curry that's on the Golden State Warriors. He is a NBA player that makes about $40 million. You know, I think it was in his last contract. He's definitely well known if you watch the NBA. You know, his wife, you know, also she was, you know, an actress. She has her own, you know, cooking show. So she's definitely well known. You've seen her probably before. If you haven't, you probably known the face and know the name. So she went on Jada Smith's Red Table Talk, and they was discussing some issues, and she brought up an interesting conversation about how she feels in relation to her husband and how all the women kind of come at him. But it was interesting. What got people going is what she said about herself. Let's roll that short clip.
Thing that really bothers me and, like, honestly has given me a sense of a little bit of an insecurity is the fact that, yeah, like, there are all these women, like, throwing themselves, but me, like, the past 10 years, like, I don't have any of that. Like, I have zero, this sounds weird, but, like, male attention. And so then, like, I begin to internalize it, and I'm like, is something wrong with
me?
You're
not looking. You're not looking.
But I'm going to tell you something else, too. When your radar's turned off, because I dealt with that for years, too, like, and I was young, like you.
Yeah,
like, oh, my God.
Fair.
I mean.
Because I don't want it, but it'd be nice to know that, like, someone's looking.
But when your radar.
Now, there's a lot of people talking about this, and I'm going to speak about it definitely from not just a content creator aspect, but just being a husband. I'm a married man. And, you know, there's some people talking about this, and they don't know the dynamics of, you know, what happens with marriage. And they kind of going on this, especially, I'm talking about a lot of guys. I'm not talking about the women. They going on, you see, that's why you don't need to get with these women and marry them, because look what they do. I mean, she getting all this money and she's still complaining. That's what they're going to say. But now me speaking as a husband, and I want to talk about how men feel too, just in general as well, because when I heard it, I said, man, that's kind of messed up what she's stating. But when I first initially heard it, to a man, especially just a husband. Now you're thinking, okay, he has all these Instagram females, groupies, whatever, coming at him. This is most men would think. He's not cheating. We even heard he's cheating. We haven't seen no pictures of some side chick that he's been with, because you know good and well how scandalous these females are. They would expose that quickly, okay? So he is bringing home his $40 million check to his wife, to their children, okay? He's providing a life that most people would even dream of for his family. A man says, look, I married her. She's my wife. She's the woman for me. And for her to say what she said in that aspect, and especially in that group of women and everyone seeing it, it definitely going to have him feeling some sort of way. It is, because it was public. Some things should not be said in public. And if you're having that kind of conversation with women, I know women talk about all kinds of things. Don't put that on social media. I understand she's doing a little, you know, table talk with them. But just some things should not be put to the public, because when you put certain issues out or insecurities that you have out to the public, now you invite the public into your relationship. And the last thing you need to do is invite the public into your private relationship, whatever the issues may be. Now, for her to say that she's insecure, knowing these scandalous women, now they're going to be extra. Because before, they didn't know how she would respond to that. But now she said that she's insecure about it. They're going to be extra. They're going to do a lot more or whatever. And that's one aspect of it. Then, you know, she's saying about the male attention part. I mean, you want guys jumping in your DM? I mean, that's what's going to happen. And then the thing is, what Ayesha need to understand is this. A lot of guys don't say nothing to her for one reason alone. They respect you. And you have carried yourself in a way of respect. Ayesha don't understand that a lot of brothers used her as a type in their videos to say, you need to present yourself like Ayesha Curry. You see, she doesn't show skin. You know, she's, you know, carries herself well. She ain't got tattoos all in her neck. You know, she's, you know, with her husband. She's with her kids. She still do things for herself. There's been many videos like that describing her in that manner. She the one got the ring. She the one got the husband. There's a lot of women that complain all the time that they can't get married and yada, yada, yada. Always talking about can't get married. I know that's a relevant issue, but I'm just saying in general, she is not the one that's complaining about that. She don't have to worry about her man not providing. She not, even though he is in a position where he could easily do something outside the marriage, he don't. And as a man, and just, you know, how I would think, she would think like, man, you know, all these women want my husband, so shoot, you know, he's coming home to me, he bring everything to me. She's the one that's the prize. But she's feeling some sort of way about that. Now, I did talk to my wife about this because we went back and forth, and we do that a lot sometimes just in, well, before I do certain videos, and she explained to me how women feel. And yes, I understand women is different than us as men because we feel that, hey, I'm not cheating, I'm providing, I'm doing everything I can as a man to show you and prove to you that I do love you by doing all this. And that's how we think. But when you have kids and you have businesses, you can get so busy, so busy. Hey, I got to do this. I got to meet this deadline. He's traveling, you know, in the NBA. He got to stay working out. I mean, it's a constant job for him to do. I understand he has his time off. He has his kids. I know he hasn't seen them, you know, sometime when he's playing because he's traveling with an 82-game season. Then you have to go through the playoffs, which he's in the playoffs right now, okay? So, yes, his wife and kids may come to the games, but they can't be there all 82 games. I mean, the kids got to go to school, etc. So if they are so busy and they, let's say they may not have time for each other sometime, and sometimes you have to make time and put down the situation with the kids and the businesses and whatever and say, hold on, we need to go out. We need to take a little vacation. We need to do this and that and the third because we're not spending time with each other as a couple because you say they've been together 10 years, okay? And one thing you have to do, especially in their situation, they have the money to do it a little bit more than others. You have to put time aside for your spouse and for your relationship with her and your relationship with your husband, okay? So even though I know he's upset possibly within himself that it was, this was said publicly, you know, just the way a lot of times women are hardwired, you know, they're different from us as men. We don't need certain things that they may need. I'm just speaking just as a husband. So that's one time that I was like, you know, man, we getting too busy. We doing this and the third. We need to, you know, take some time. This is me saying that because I recognize we were just way too busy and it was starting to get on my nerves. Okay. So maybe she's not the type to speak up. And maybe in that setting, she says something. Well, you know, I ain't getting the attention because maybe I don't know if he do or not. Tell her that she looks nice. Tell her that she's beautiful. Tell her she's the only one that he wants, et cetera. I don't know, because in some men say, why does she need to hear all that? Well, some women, just women in general, like to know that they're desired and they're wanted outside of being a mom and, you know, just being a helpful wife. I mean, they need that for their personal self-esteem, because if she's feeling insecure about those women that's coming up to her husband and he's not doing anything, was obviously something isn't going on behind the scenes that it makes her feel secure enough. And she's like, I ain't worried about that. You know, he's my man. I love him. He do this. He done the third. Right. So with that being said, that's just dynamics in marriage. Now, if they do have some issue going on behind the scenes, then they can talk to somebody. But I just don't agree with the way this was brought out, you know, just in a marriage sense, because now you brought all these people into your marriage and now you got dudes in her DM and she's like posting what they're saying to her. You know what I'm saying? Like, is that the attention you wanted? You don't want that kind of attention. Then really, that's kind of what it is. What man can really follow Stephen Curry? I mean, what man, you know, I don't get it. It doesn't, you know, like I said, but that's their issues behind the scenes, obviously. But I don't think they got some big marital problems. No, because every couple can deal with that at times, especially when you have long-term relationships. Because you have to remember, when you get married the first, 2 years or so, that's like a critical stage. Then if you can get up to year five, you know, they say you can survive basically your whole life. You can do 5 years. If you can get up at least to year 10, you know, and you still got the fire going, you know, because like I said, you have to, in a relationship, keep things going. It can't just be, okay, I got her, she got me, it is what it is. You know, and like I said, as you get busy, it reminds me even of the scriptures, the cares of this world could just choke out anything. Especially when you get them kids. Lord, when you get them kids. Oh, boy. Them kids. Like I said, they take up a lot of your time. You have to, it's your kids, you have to do that with your kids. I mean, it's not the kids' fault while they're here, or the kids need you to be there. You need to be a parent, but you have to be a husband and wife. You got to be each other's friend. You have to do that. I mean, especially that's why the thing is, I always say the more success a person have, a lot of times you see them, you know, get in trouble in the area of their marriage sometime, because if they don't take care of it and make sure to take out that time for each other, like I say, especially when you got money like that, I mean, they could take off to Fiji or wherever they want to go and just chill their nerves and get somebody, you know, to watch the kids or whatever. I mean, that's what I would suggest for them to do. But even though I know that this sounds extremely bad, and as a man, trust me, if it were me, I would be very, very upset about just hearing that being presented in that manner and making me look horrible, you know, and then having all these kind of people talking about me and then talking about you. And then I'd be mad about that, too, because now you'd opened yourself up to certain criticism that wasn't there before, you know. But I don't think he's going to get so mad or something going to happen out of it. But I definitely believe it's going to be some talking behind the scenes, because, you know, I mean, she shouldn't feel insecure. If he's not out there running through these women and he's coming home to you, you shouldn't feel insecure about that. I mean, these women, all they have is to try to work on the way they look. They have nothing else going on, and then looks fade. I mean, at the end of the day, those women going to be by themselves. They probably got a bunch of baby daddies somewhere. They don't care about them or those kids. You got a husband that's not only providing, but he's a father. You know, like I said, you winning. 2,000% you winning. You got business. You got, you know, your own things going on. These little women don't got nothing going on. They got crap. That's why they looking at your husband as a lottery ticket if they can get at him. Like I said, please. I mean, use those women to fuel your self-esteem. Say, shoot, they want what I got. Hey, you know, it is what it is. I ain't worried about it. I mean, they wish they could have what I have. Use that. Don't, like I said, because when you say male attention, and any man, they hear that, he's going to say, well, man, she wants some other dude? I mean, any man going to feel that way? I mean, but I understand some men will say, see, the women, all they want is men attention. And men. Look, the husband or any man would feel a certain way about that, but take care of your relationship behind the scenes. Let's not try to put y'all situation out there like this has already been done, because it's going to cause some issues. I already see it's going to cause some issues, not divorce issues, but putting all these people in your situation. Because now some of the NBA guys are commenting and saying, oh, yeah, she's beautiful. She ain't got nothing to worry about. Even though they may just saying it, they're not saying it to be disrespectful, but the fact is you put him in a peculiar situation in the middle of the playoffs, which he shouldn't be dealing with at all. Please keep your marriage and all your relationship off the internet, please. Well, leave me a comment that knows the thing about this particular story with Ayesha Curry. I just think she just needs to assess what she has and talk with him behind the scenes and keep your situation. I'm going to keep saying this to every y'all. Keep your situation off the internet. Talk behind the scenes. Go to a counselor, whatever you got to do to talk about your issues and problems, but never on the internet, because people will be involved in your situation. They have no dealing or no details of anything that's going on.